Hallelujah.
It's been a dry season in your life, but you gotta prove that you.
Spoken.
For God has spoken.
And you think churches are not for me. So I'm going to ask you a question. And I know you will respond to God. But get ready for this. Listen. When will it come through?
Every time.
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 I give myself away. Service, so I'm going to be obedient to what our leader has asked. We're going to do what God has called us to do, and we're going to get on out of the way. For those of you that have your word, I'll be coming from Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, beginning at verse 11. And when you have found it, please stand for the reading of the word. It's a very familiar passage. Beginning at verse 11, it reads, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." You may be seated. Using for a subject today, it's all a part of the plan. Life is so uneasy at times, and certainly unpredictable. Sometimes things just don't go the way we want them to, or how we have planned. It's so frustrating when you have this vision of how you want things to be, and it just doesn't pan out. As we have embarked upon a new year, I know many people have said 2023, they have all these visions and a new year and things they have declared for themselves. But I just want to encourage you all today to hold on to the fact that there is a plan for your life and a promise from the Good Shepherd. He gave his life for you that you may have life. Knowing that the Great I Am has a plan for your life ought to bring you some peace of mind and some hope today. Wouldn't things be much easier to accept when you change your perspective and can acknowledge that a plan for your life has already been set? Your purpose in this life is important. Your creation is all a part of the plan that originated from glory. The plans for your life established by heaven is for you to prosper, have no harm, and to have a future filled with hope. Knowing that when we seek after the Creator of everything, with all of our hearts, He hears us. What is profound to me is in verse 12 through 13. "When you call on me and come pray to me, I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." God requires us to seek Him with all of our heart. When you seek Him with the whole heart, then you will find Him. You can't halfway approach God and expect to have the plan that He has for you completely fulfilled. When He went to the cross for you, He didn't halfway do it. He sacrificed it all for you to have salvation and eternal life. I know when we talk about the plans God has for our life, we automatically begin to think of prosperity, financial blessing, and things. But there's far more to it than that. We all want to be prosperous. We all want financial freedom and security. We all want nice things. But in 3 John chapter 1, verses 1 and 2, it says, "Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in good health, just as your soul prospers." The most important piece of this is for your soul to prosper. All of these things on this side is surely going to pass away. But your soul, that's eternal. That's the biggest part of the plan. Don't get me wrong, we are all natural beings living in a natural world. And our days are not going to be full of sunshine, rainbows, glitter, or dancing in tulips. For it is written in Job chapter 14 and verse 1, "Man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble." God has already let us know that it won't always be easy. But His plan for us gives us hope and reassurance. He has told us we have just a few days on this side. And it isn't always going to be the most simple walk you've ever done. But it all won't be hard either. You're going to have some mountain highs and some valley lows. You're going to have some days with laughter. You're going to have some days with tears. But in the end, John chapter 10 and verse 10 reminds us, Jesus said, "The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. But I have come that you may have life, and life more abundantly." In the end, we already know we win. I believe in my heart that everyone in this church today is saved. I believe that everyone has accepted the gift of eternal life. I believe that everyone here has an appreciation for the plan on your life. I believe that everyone here has life through Jesus and has it more abundantly. I'm not long-winded, so bear with me just a little bit longer. When we talk about the plan, what is the plan? Let me put it to you in this perspective. You ever seen kids throwing a fit, a complete tantrum, because they want a toy in the store, but mommy or daddy said no? Or they throw a fit because they want a snack or some junk before dinner, and again, mommy and daddy said no. For the most part, parents have the best interests of their child at heart. They want you to be the forefront and the center of everything they do. But at times, your parents are going to say no. Not to be mean, not to be cruel, but because what the child wants, they have something far greater for them. Maybe what they want is not a part of the plan at this time, but later, if you can just be still, if you can just be quiet, if you could just not throw a fit, the parents may have that plan to get you something far greater than what you asked for at this moment. Sometimes parents say no because they are trying to prevent you unnecessary stomach pains, moans, groans, and heartache through the night. Because if we cave in and buy that toy that's cheaply made and not of good quality, in 10 minutes it's going to be broke, and that child's tonsils is going to be showing because they're sitting there with that mouth open hollering, wanting something else again. But if you would have just been still and waited, I could have went a little further down and got you something of good quality. We don't always know the why of rejection, but sometimes that no has spared you. The same way our earthly parents don't mind to hurt your feelings or let you down to spare you pain, how much more will our God do? How many of us have begged and pleaded with God for something we knew we just had to have? That right there is just for me. We overrode all warning signs from heaven. He asked us to stop before we made a mess, but we kept going. And then there you have it. What you got is no good for you. Now you're laying awake at night, tossing and turning in the midnight hours, because that was not a part of his plan. He has something for you, something far better, but we don't listen. Sometimes his rejection is our divine protection, because it's not a part of his plan. God has not created us for misery, heartache, and heartbreak. The good shepherd has a good plan for you. The plan has everything to do with your well-being and your wholeness. He wants you whole naturally, physically, mentally, emotionally, but most important, spiritually. God wants you to do well. He wants you to be well. After all, he formed you in his image. He knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb. He knows every hair on your head, and he can call you by name. He's with you every second of your life. He has promised to never leave you nor forsake you. When God sent his son to earth, you was a part of the plan. When his son went to the cross, you was a part of the plan. When Jesus dropped his head and breathed his last, you was a part of the plan. When Jesus was placed in that tomb and wrapped in grave cloths, you was a part of the plan. When he rose on the third day, conquering death and grave by redeeming mankind, you was a part of the plan. What is the plan for you, you may ask? Well, I don't know. Each one of us have different plans. The plan he has for me is not the plan he has for you. The plan he has for you is not the plan he has for your children, your brother, or your sister. Each of us have plans that are unique and formulated just for you. But what I can tell you as a child of the Most High is that God is our provider. That's a part of the plan. He's a heavy load bearer. That's a part of the plan. He's the lily in the valley. That's a part of the plan. He's your wonderful counselor. That's a part of the plan. He's the great I am. That's a part of the plan. He's our redeemer. That's a part of the plan. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. That's a part of the plan. This plan is like none other, and I can go on because he's an on-time God. That's a part of the plan. He's a healer and a deliverer. That's a part of the plan. He's the lion and the lamb. That's a part of the plan. If my Aunt Suzanne was here today, I would tell her that he's a comforter in our time of trouble. That's a part of the plan. He brings you peace in your mourning. That's a part of the plan. He's a mother to the motherless and a father to the fatherless. That's part of the plan. Yeah. He is sweeter than the honey from a honeycomb. Yeah. That's a part of the plan. He's a bridge over troubled water. That's a part of the plan. He's peace in the midst of the storm. That's a part of the plan. He's your all in all. That's a part of the plan. He's your leaning post. That's a part of the plan. He's your light in darkness. That's a part of the plan. He's King of Kings and Lord of Lords. That's a part of the plan. He's your protector. That's a part of the plan. He's your battle axe in a battle.
It's already paid in full. All you gotta do is sign.